The hepatocytes are polygonal. Two sites are engaged in the formation of the sinusoids, but the space between the hepatocytes is forming the bile canal coli. There is single layer of hepatocytes and having polygonal sieve. So there is formation of the bile canal coli. Here we can see more view of the hepatic cord, arranged like disc in the wall, neuralium appearance. This is a single layer hepatic cord or hepatic lamina, which is having a single layer of the hepatocytes. The bile duct, the portal veins, hepatic artery. Blood is coming in these cords from the portal vein, from the hepatic artery, and draining in central vein. Simply, we can understand this all architecture by using a book. When we open the multiple pages of a book, the spine of the book is the central vein, and the pages of the book are the cords or laminae of the hepatocytes. And bile is running in this direction through this chain cord to be drained in the bile duct radical. So this is the other section of the cord. Now we can reconstruct the hepatic lobule. Here I will reconstruct the hepatic lobule. Six portal canals, portal triads, or portal tracts, and in the center there is hepatic or central vein. So this is the architecture reconstructed hepatic lobule. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. This is hexagonal, showing six corners which are having portal rods, portal canals or portal tract, and in the center there is central or centrilobular vein. So this is the classical hepatic lobule. But in primates, what we see on the outermost surface, there is no connective tissue limiting membrane or connective tissue sheath which delineate one hepatic lobule to the other. But in lower animals like pigs, we can see well-defined hepatic lobule. So this lobule is simply a part of liver. There are 1 million lobules which is draining by a central vein. It is neither structure nor functional unit of the liver. It is simply part of the liver which is drained by a single central vein. So this is the classical hepatic lobule. Now after a break, I will talk about the portal lobe or the hepatic acinus or liver acinus. These are the other theories which are used to study the parenchyma and stroma of the liver.